Me don't be got on the pequena. Me don't be got on the pequena. Me don't be got. E quando ela veio de lá, me preparei de cá, bati o pé no chão, castiguei a mulher não bigada. Aí, meu camarada, virou o negócio, foi, virou frege, viu? Todo santo dia, durante 29 dias de revista, nós cantávamos Sebastiana 3-4 vezes. Certo? Então foi onde veio Sebastiana. Coco Sebastiana. Thank you. castiguei a mulher na umbigada. Aí, meu camarada, virou o negócio. Foi, virou velho. Castiguei a mulher na umbigada. Aí, meu camarada, virou o negócio. Foi, virou velho.
That produced a situation that demanded a song like that. Feelings. Conditions that produced feelings. Demanded feelings. Demanded a song like that. Situation. Do not believe. Demand. Condition. Produce. Situation. Do not believe. Demand. Condition. Produce. Situation. Do not believe. Demand. Condition. Produce. Situation.
Demand produce condition. Do not believe. Situation. Demand produce. This is a project. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that would be good. Well, thanks for coming this spring day. There's a lot of snow in the spring. I come from Brazil, so we don't have winter, we have one thing that is hot. So it's kind of weird to experience that amount of cold during the year and expect to finish, but it's ending. I think you're hopeful, as me. Wow, this is intense. Okay.
Do we have working
other stuff? Huh? Yeah. Okay. Are you more comfortable with that? Can you turn down a little bit because it's kind of too much? Too much, too much, too much, especially mid. Perfect, thanks. So, I have 3,000 things to tell you today. So, I have to pick up kind of 5 out of this 3,000. It's a hard task. I'm totally open to move towards something completely different than what I planned, if you lead me to that. But I'm going to propose some stuff. Basically, there are like 2 parts of this presentation. One is to talk about the relationship with the machine and how we can have other experiences instead of just playing over the machine. And wow, I have some filtering going on. Now I think it's over. What are you hearing? Like, yeah, it's the filtering that wasn't. Yeah. I have a filter. Yeah. So, and the other thing is rhythm, which is something I've spent 20 years of my life trying to figure out stuff about, and that I want to share some ideas and discuss with you. Your ideas also, I want to really listen to your approach to rhythm. So I'm going to divide in a way that I start talking about rhythm, and then I talk about the machine. What do you think about that?
Yes, very good.
Cool. I might use a machine, though, to talk about rhythm at a certain point, because I made a software to present to you this talk. And it's a visualization software, something that I promised myself 4 years ago I would do, and I never done. So this time I said I'm going to do that for the workshop because I want to see the thing. And it kind of works. So I'm happy to show that in the middle of the presentation about rhythm. I wanted to use that guy. So I'm going to jump here. You see me, right? If I... Cool. So the first thing that I think it's interesting, I need the guy. So this is the pandeiro. Pandeiro is a frame drum, tambourine, Brazilian tambourine. And we play in a specific way. Okay? It's, I think, the only frame drum in the world that is played like that. Most all frame drums are played like that, which is physically more intelligent because you're making, whoa, you're making the sound with the hand that also holds. This way, you're holding and making the sound with the other hand. So you're having the whole weight here, and this hand is completely free. But that's the way we play in Brazil. Probably this is a Middle East instrument. It's, you can see in many pictures in Greece and Egypt, you see pandeiros around there. This probably came from the Portuguese influence, so it's not an African drum, but it's played. I have to turn that off because now I need just the raw. Where are you? Thank you.
Okay. So he doesn't want to turn off. Works. So so this guy in Brazil, we play in many situations, samba, choro. Choro is the ancient samba. Choro is like our jazz, basically. And for sure, the way we play it is completely related to the African rhythms and to the African Afro-Brazilian religion. So this is an instrument that came from Europe or from Portugal, but became completely related to the African-Brazilian rhythms. So we don't have enough pandeiros for every one of you play, but we have enough mouths for everyone of you play. So I'll invite you to play mouth pandeiro, which is a new instrument that you're gonna create right now. So basically, tiki tika tunki tika taki tika tunki tika taki tika tunki tika taki tika tunki tika taki tika tungun dungun taki tika tunki taki tika tungun dungun taki tika tunki tika taki tika tungun dungun taki tika tunki tika taki tika tungun dungun taki tika tunki tika taki tika tungun dungun dun. Perfect. No need for pandeiros. Cool. So basically, the idea is that verbalizing rhythm is something that is a very important tool. Many traditions use that. Indians, many traditions from Africa use verbalization as a way of teaching and understanding rhythm before playing. In this way, so specifically in the pandeiro, I'm going to explain some things that are related to the technique I use, that I developed. And it makes us be able to express a bigger amount of phrases. So I'm going to explain basically what happens here. We have, as you saw, ta, tum, and chiki chiki chiki, right? So basically, that's what we have here in this instrument. Ta, tum, and chi. Ta, we play in the middle. Ta, tum, so a bassy sound, tum, and chi, we play here. Okay? So what happens is that, as you saw, I use an axis, right? So everything that I play comes from chiki 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 chi, and I choose the notes I want to play here. Okay, so basically, I have ta, tum, and chi, but I have to be able to play ta, tum, and chi, ta, tum, and chi. Why that? Imagine I don't have tum here. Okay, so I have tum just here. Okay. So what happens is the phrases I can play will be just with this tune, not with tune here. What happens? So once I have tune here, I have a huge amount of phrases. As you said, I have the upbeats. So basically, it happens exactly the same with your pandeiro there in you. Ta, tum, and chi won't be enough. Because if you want to ta 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 ta, it's much harder than taka 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 ta. Taka. Taka taka. If you have ta, it's an, you do it with your tongue doing like that. Ta ta, right? But if you do ka 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 ka. Ka, when you do ka, your the very tip of your tongue, right? The tip of your tongue is, it's there. It's not used. So if you do ka 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 ka, it's one thing. But if you do ta ka 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 ta ta ka ta ka ta ka ta ka ta, you're using one side of your tongue and the other side of your tongue. So you're having exactly the same thing as I'm having here. So chiki 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 chiki. So you saw it's a nice instrument, the pandeiro, right? You just have it in your mouth, and it works. And it's exactly that we do with this technique that I developed. The difference of the technique I use to the technique of my masters, which are Marco Suzano and Jorginho do Pandeiro. You should check them out. These are like unbelievable pandeiro players. Jorginho, George, with a J, Jorginho, he's an older guy, and he made the whole tradition of pandeiro become a beautiful ballet, basically. That's what he does. And Marco Suzano is the guy that made the... So what he made was he used the pandeiro to do a funk beat and many other stuff, but things that are not from our culture. So he opened the door for us. He just said, go on. You can do a lot of stuff with that. But their technique, don't use the ta-ka-ta-ka-ta-ka-ta-ka-ta idea. They just have the ta. They don't have the, sorry, they have the ta, yeah. They don't have the ka. No, sorry, they have the ka and they don't have the ta. So it's quite impressive because you cannot do upbeats. To me, it was something that was constraining me to a certain level that I had to create the ta. Yeah. So when I did the ta and I had the ka, then I taka 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 taka, I can do instead of just, because they have the ka. The ka is the pa, the ta, with that part. So they have it here. So basically what happens is that when Marco Suzano does his funk, he puts the pa. But I missed. So if I don't have the ka, 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 I'm stuck in many phrases that I wanted to express, I wasn't able to. So then I developed this idea of having ta, ka, tum, kum, chiki, which is the natural chiki. Chiki is all over. Tunkun is also known in the traditional technique. Tungun dungun dun. It's something already used in the traditional technique, okay? Anyway, this is just a specificity of this technique, but it's nice that now you have the pandeiro in your mouth. Do I need to write down this taka tunkun? No, it's quite. So one thing that is interesting, taka. If you do it very fast, taka 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 taka, instead of taka 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 taka, you can do daga 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 daga. So it makes it even faster. So every time you say daga 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 daga, it's the same as taka 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 tas, but it's softer, so you can do it faster. Okay. Cool. So now we can start to talk about stuff using the same language. Basically, one of the things that always impressed me was the idea of having cycles of different length together, which people usually call it as polyrhythms or polymetrics. I prefer to always refer to cycles as cycles. And I don't go into exactly which matrix is better to write, or and you, I'm pretty much sure that you can find the way of writing. But basically, I think the main issue in polyrhythmics situations is when you have cycles that don't match the size. So things turn in different velocities and they come along at a certain point. If they turn in different velocities, they will hit each other at a certain point, right? Because if we have a subdivision, this subdivision is locking us, which doesn't happen to planets, which is exactly the same thing. So we are in a planet that turns around a star, and there's a lot of planets going around. So basically what they're doing is polyrhythms. That's exactly what they're doing. And our cells are always doing polyrhythms too, because not only, I mean, if you're alive, and we are all alive here, there are two cycles that make you alive here, which are this guy, and who else? Otherwise, just him wouldn't be enough. There is that too, but that is not so important as this guy. So you have a polyrhythm built in. There's no way you're gonna get rid of it unless you do a lot of meditation, and it's long path. So basically, what I'm saying that because I really believe that polyrhythmic, and that is just a question of looking at things as they are and figuring out that it's a huge orchestration of polyrhythms that we are completely involved. For example, April 15th. April 15th is a beat that is always there in our ear, right? The tax. I mean, you live your life, and then there's this rah, this thing that comes in, and oh, completely out of, and you don't want to stop to prepare to that beat, but it's oh, it comes in. So it is right? No, and with that many others. So let's start to play stuff. Taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chika taki 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 taki chika 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 exchange. Continue. Kataki chika taki 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 chikunchiki taki chikunchiki taki chikunchiki taki chikunchiki taki chikunchiki. 3-4, right? Taki chikata, it's a samba. Taki chika taki chika taki chika taki chika taki chika taki chikata taki chikunchiki taki chikunchiki. It's a 6-8 we find all over. Cool. So this is too easy, I know. But it's better to start from the too easy. I don't know if you realized that you were super locked. There was not even once So congratulations. And I think you realize that the kichi 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 is very important for that to be locked. If not explicitly, mentally. Okay? So let's do without it. Let's see if it's harder or not. Okay? Ta, 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 kum, 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 ta. Yeah, you're too trained. Cool. So now, let's do. So let's do a little bit harder. Ta? Huh? If you have propositions, I'm totally open to it. Ta, 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 ta. Ta kum, 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 ta 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 kum, ta kum, ta 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 kum, ta kum, ta ta kum, ta ta kum, ta, ta, 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 kum, ta. So, I mean, we're far out. No issues with synchronization at all, which is beautiful. And we don't, basically the idea is that the chiki 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 chi is going to always lock us. So whenever we need, let's chiki chiki chik, and then it's going to work out. I think, I don't know what time is it.
It's five.
Cool. So I think it's time for us to present.
You want me to say what kind of rhythms you were using there? They were doing like the five.
Yeah. Perfect. Like, yeah, we can talk about that. Sorry. We were doing a bunch of stuff. We started with five.
Right.
We started with tak, chik, tak, chik, tak, chik. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So they were doing that. And then they did tak tak ch, tak tak ch, taki taki chi. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Okay? So this is a five. It's a cycle in five. With four, this creates a moment of tension and then back to the one, as always. And then they were doing, then we started with a three, right?
Yeah, then we did.
3, 3, 4. Yeah. Takachi, tak. Yeah. How was it? I remember. Takachi, kachiki, takachi, takachi, kachiki, tak. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. Which is exactly the five. It's another five. It's a 10. But it's going to match with the five. So it's not going to go out of sync. Okay. Then they started doing the three. Takachi, 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 takachi. And then they started doing the seven, and then they joined. Take, take, takachi, take, take, takachi. So this idea of getting groups of twos and threes and building up cycles of an odd number of beats, this is an idea that is very old. You find a lot in Indian music, and you find in many places, in many approaches, in the jazz world, you see a lot of people working with that. And I think it's a very nice way of keeping track, because it's small groups that don't let us lose track of the size of the cycles. Okay? So the idea is that any rhythm can be divided into groups of twos and threes, which is exactly what we are doing. At most, we are doing four, which is also something quite natural for us to build. Okay? Cool. Something else? Thanks for reminding me of analyzing, because you played so nice that I was already skipping that analysis. So I wanted to present you a piece, a duo that I'm gonna play with my friend Wyatt Burtz, who is a student of mine. And I wanna come from that to analyze this piece, because this piece has some stuff going on. So I wanna show you the piece, and then we do, okay? Well, now I have to make it work. Okay. Need you lights here? Can we have light from here? Or that's okay, right? It's okay, we can make it. Is it on? I don't think. Is it on? The
Yeah.
Not mine, his. I don't think so. Is it?
It's
sound. Okay. Maybe a little bit more?
You can't. I don't believe you can those all on.
It's perfect, man. Look at this. Amazing.
so nervous. You guys are so good looking.
So, are you ready to play that? You play?
Yeah.
We'll talk later then. So I wanted to talk about some stuff that happened, but I'm totally open to questions about that. If you could you hear the two banderos, and do you have questions about what happened?
Can you talk a little bit about the two basic ways that rhythm is organized, additive on one side and divisive on the other? Because I could definitely hear, you know, divisive rhythms, but I read in Wikipedia that when you have odd rhythms, 5, 4, 7, 4, 9, 4, it can't be divisive because you can't divide 5 or 7 evenly.
Mm, thanks so much.
So then it becomes additive. It's then 3 plus 2. But then I'm confused because now I heard like 5, but I'm thinking if you divide 5, if you double 5, it then becomes 10, right?
Yeah.
And then you can divide 10 into groups of, I don't know, 4, 4, and 2, maybe. So can you talk a little bit about, you know, divisive and additive rhythms as applied to your...
Mm-hmm. Okay, so there in the piece, there is a lot of situations that where that happens. Basically, I don't know if you realize, but this... Here, what's happening, it's something that I usually work with, which is, this is what I call a projection. So I didn't talk much about subdivision because you were so fast on building up the thing that I felt it's quite natural for you to understand. But if we start from the very beginning, the idea is that once you have a pulse, you can put three notes. Sorry. Four. One, two, so 7. So this is 9, and so on. Sorry. So basically, the idea is that the pulse can be subdivided. So, as the way you want during the piece. This is not so used in the jazz and popular music. Now it's getting more use. This is you find in classical music. Stravinsky did that. The 20th century is full of that possibility, right? And you find in folk music, Macedonian music, you find in the East a lot of stuff. And of course, in India. In India, it's like a different chapter. You find anything in India. In terms of rhythm, there's nothing that they didn't search. They didn't search and build. And in Africa, you find stuff that you don't really know if it, because four is not for sure. And it's not really three, so it's probably something. But then the idea of subdividing is a much more Western idea. That is a need that we have in terms of analysis, but that musically it's not so needed. I mean, you can just hear things and go for it, you know, for sure. I mean, that's what I believe. I believe for sure the knowledge and the analysis are a very important step, but I completely believe that the musician can be absolutely self-taught and inspired by sounds and do that beautifully his whole life without even realizing, not even once, what he was doing in the Western approach, because he's for sure realizing everything he's doing. It's not that you need to analyze rationally to be able to be in control of the things. You can analyze in many other deep ways, I believe, too. But that's a more complex. It comes with the planets and polyrhythmic stuff that we're talking. If we come back to the subdivision, basically, the idea of changing the amount of notes that you have in a pulse, it's not as developed, in my opinion, as it should be. This is a call I make for you. You for sure write music. Please check it out. That possibility of... kind of thing, if it's fluid in the playing, I think it's a huge color. In my opinion, it's kind of like opening a door to a certain other dimension. That's the feeling I have when I'm playing that, is that if I'm in four, even the four and six, then I'm back to this dimension. I went to the five dimension and came back. So it's like, in my feeling, it's like a harmonic rhythm, because it creates a position where you are that is not exactly as you were, and you create tension, so it creates harmony. If you're I feel this is, it's a harmonic experience, although you're not necessarily doing. And this, the interesting is that this is a different dimension of the harmony, because you can put that plus harmony doing other stuff, you create something that can be very complex and interesting, I think. So it's a call I do, because I feel like it's something that is not as spread as it should, this kind of change. And with that, it comes, of course, the question of accenting in groups. Because accenting groups and subdividing, they are a couple that you can never lose track of. We just did the accent, the grouping we've just worked on, right? It's, you did the five and the four, so then you, and which one is the beat? depends on the music you are or the session you are in the music. There's one that is in five, and then you accent and do stuff in four on the top of it. And that creates, that's what I, when I talk about this different dimension, that's the feeling I have. Once you go to this five thing, then from here you can build structures that are even further on. You can build a tree structure on the top of it. And then basically, I mean, if you have enough strength of concentration, you can go very far in that.
There is a distinction, though, between what we did and what you do now. Because what we did was everything was divided in cheeky, cheeky, cheeky,
yeah.
but grouping it into threes, fives, sevens, right?
Yeah.
The subdivision was always the same.
Yeah.
But what you just did now was actually you fit five into a specific length, which is incredibly hard to do. I mean, I don't think we would have been able to do that in this setting. You know what I'm saying?
Let's do it right now. Taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chitaka taka chitaka taka chitaka taka chitaka taka chitaka taka chitaka taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chitaka 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 taka taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chika taka. Again to the five now. Taka chitaka taka chika chitaka taka chitaka taka chitaka taka chitaka taka chitaka. Four. Taka chika taka chika taka chika taka chika taka.